Saudações terráqueos, aqui é o Wesley do blog Eptese etc, com mais um vídeo ufológico para vocês. Olá amigos, primeiramente eu gostaria de dizer que eu não tinha a intenção de revelar publicamente esse meu avistamento. Tanto é que levei um ano para decidir se publicava ou não. O motivo é bem simples, eu fiquei muito frustrado por não ter conseguido fazer um registro em vídeo ou foto do objeto que avistei. Por ser uma pessoa que pesquisa ufologia há muitos anos, eu me senti na obrigação de ter feito algum registro do objeto. Por um vacilo não consegui, e me cobrei muito por isso. No entanto, como liberei este relato de avistamento para um amigo ufólogo publicar em seu futuro livro, não posso deixar de publicá-lo no meu canal e blog. Relatei esse avistamento para poucas pessoas dentro destes 365 dias, mas agora me sinto um pouco mais confortável para relatar ao público em geral. Em 8 de outubro de 2017, parti de Campinas para o Rio de Janeiro em viagem de férias pela companhia aérea Azul. O avião decolou aproximadamente 8 horas e 25 minutos, com previsão de pouso no Rio de Janeiro por volta das 9 horas e 20 minutos. A viagem seguia normal, em voo de cruzeiro, quando aproximadamente 9 horas da manhã, senti uma grande necessidade de olhar pela janela do avião. Eu não fazia a viagem na poltrona da janela. Minha filha de 9 anos estava lá. Quando olhei pela janela, ao longe, por cima de um chão de nuvens, vi um objeto muito estranho. Fiquei estupefacto, trêmulo e quase paralisado por alguns instantes. O objeto era totalmente negro e tinha o formato de halteres, aqueles pezinhos de academia que possuem extremidades arredondadas. Alertei minha filha de que estava vendo um OVNI. Ela me perguntou onde e, ao mesmo tempo em que tentava explicar a ela o exato local, peguei meu celular no bolso para fazer um vídeo. Com a mão trêmula, tive dificuldades para destravar a tela do smartphone. Quando destravei, fui direto até a câmera e, sem pensar muito, já cliquei no botão REC e comecei a gravar. Foi um grande erro, o qual não me perdoou até o dia de hoje. Fui alertado pela minha filha de que o celular estava no modo selfie, ou seja, com o apavoramento em tentar registrar o fato tão insólito, cliquei no botão REC e fiquei olhando o objeto a olho nu, sem olhar no celular, e acabei por filmar o meu próprio rosto. Quando avisado por minha filha, lamentei e tratei de mudar imediatamente o celular do modo selfie para o modo normal. Porém, quando mudava, pude ver o insólito objeto adentrar o chão de nuvens que estava logo abaixo dele. Mesmo assim, após isso, fiz um vídeo de 2 minutos, o qual guardo comigo, mas para minha tristeza, o objeto não mais apareceu. Posteriormente, ao ver um avião a uma distância similar à que vi o objeto, calculei que aquele OVNI pudesse ter aproximadamente o tamanho de um avião Boeing. Pelo tempo de voo que havia, no momento do avistamento, calculei onde estaria o avião, usando como referência o mapa de rota da viagem através do Google Maps. Como no momento do avistamento havia cerca de 35 minutos de viagem, de um total de 55 minutos, estávamos por volta de 9 minutos à frente da metade da rota. Partindo deste cálculo, acredito que o avião poderia estar logo acima do Parque Nacional da Serra de Bocaina, local bucólico e de grande incidência de avistamentos ufológicos. É difícil contar essa história, haja vista que eu, pesquisador de ufologia há 17 anos, blogueiro ufológico há 8 anos, tive uma grande oportunidade de fazer um raro e incrível registro do fenômeno, o qual pesquiso e por um vacilo não consegui registrar. Nem que fosse por alguns míseros segundos, algo incrível e que marcou muito a minha vida. Eu, particularmente, não conhecia casos que envolvessem objetos não identificados no formato de halteres. Após este contato de primeiro grau, passei a pesquisar casos com objetos semelhantes e descobri alguns. Alguns bem interessantes ocorridos pelo mundo com o mesmo tipo de aeronave.
The object that you see is a computer graphic of a UFO witnessed by three hunters. The object came within 400 feet of the three men, and they observed this object for more than 6 minutes. The unique part of this sighting is the background of the primary witness. He works with advanced technology for the Department of Defense on electromagnetic and laser systems. He wishes to remain anonymous due to his work, but he desires that other scientists may look at this and possibly help him determine what and something about this object. Listen to these experts from his story.
It was August 28th, 2013. Approximate time of the event is about 9:40 p.m. And I was picked up by witness number two, who was driving the vehicle, and he had with him witness number three as well, already in the vehicle. We were driving down this basically a logging road and trying to make our way back to the main highway section. The vehicle was at a low enough altitude that we could actually see it through the you could see it through the windshield. You did not have to be crouched down or anything. It was relatively low. If I were to estimate its altitude, it was probably in the I'm going to say 150 to 175 feet of elevation. That was probably the highest it was at anyone. And I told the witness that was driving, and I said, stop the vehicle. And he stopped it, and shut it off. And we sat there and observed the thing. And I immediately was going for my, I said, there's no way that this vehicle can turn off my rifle sight. So I had a brand new Nikon 3x9 by 50 rifle scope. So I grabbed my rifle and rifle scope attached to it out of my pack. I had my windows down, so I was I immediately hung it out the side of the vehicle, and I opened the side door, and I was observing this craft. And the very first thing that was intense was just how bright this thing was. It was spectacular. Having been involved with optical systems in the past, I mean, we're talking about a vehicle that this thing looked like a stadium lighting kind of scenario. It was brilliant in the amount of light that it was creating, and the lights that it emitted were not incoherent light. It was coherent light. It was salty to my eyes. It was just as if I was looking at into a laser that had been passed through a diffraction gradient or something of that nature. It was not a focused laser. It was a defocused laser. And both the other witnesses were extremely worked up about this. They were, in fact, one of them said, "What is it? What is it?" And I said, "I'm not sure what it is." The other one said, "Just shoot it," like he wanted me to actually shoot a rifle round into this thing. And I said, I can't shoot a round into something that I can't identify. And this is a vehicle that was extraordinary. And I said, "You guys just need to be patient and let me observe this thing for the next minute or so that I can take in all these details." So over the next couple minutes time period, I literally was making just a terrific number of mental notes as to what I was observing. Because I was using a rifle scope that had a fixed objective focus, I could actually zoom in and make mental notes as to the scale and size of things. This vehicle was, it was huge. It's rough dimensions about a, now that we've come back and made calculations, about 170 feet in length, about 60, probably 55 to 60 feet in diameter on the outer disc sections, and about 20 or 21 feet thick. Had just an amazing look to it. The vehicle looked as if it was made out of a forged piece of mercury. It was brilliant and polished, and there was absolutely no lines whatsoever, no rivets. Immediately, I'm a pilot, and I was immediately looking for all of the things you would normally see in an aircraft. I was looking for and the lines for the fuselage that would indicate a door or indicate banner landing gear, or you know, even looking for a place for, you know, where's the propulsion. After the vehicle got a quarter mile away from us, the field energy strength was low enough that I actually was able to get the camera to boot up. And it recorded that electronic signature as part of the video in that 2 or 3 minute time period. So we've been studying that. Really, this is a hope that we can reach out to other possible people that have either similar kinds of experiences and or might be involved in having been involved in some kind of high frequency RF field kind of generation systems. Possibly that could be a defense pass, that could be advanced scientist in other fields. But the primary reason for sharing all this is I'm looking for help. And I want to try to figure out how this vehicle actually flew.
On this page, you will find a link to the full 40-minute video if you would like to see that. There is also a 17-page white paper that was written by the witness that is available. If you would like a copy, please look at the email address to send a request on this page, and we will send you a copy. The witness, his objective is to find scientists like himself who can help him.
Obrigado por assistir e até o próximo vídeo. É Tese etc. Nunca estivemos sós.
É Tese etc.